Hey guys, welcome to Around the House with Calvin, and we are here on the Hampton River in a beautiful estate on a beautiful day in St. Simons Island, Georgia, 194 Hampton Point Drive, and there are amazing views and amazing things about being on the river here, but also the harsh elements can be pretty tough on your house. So let's go see what exactly problems we got and how we're going to remediate them. So here, guys, so we have this beautiful, this kind of castle architecture with some nice Spanish style stone and some limestone, and have a great sections with these different turrets coming up and the gable ends. Looks really nice. But the number one thing that this particular couple and client, they want is a cleaner look, a more pristine, more situated and structural look than so much of an old world. So we're gonna tone it down a bit as far as old world and rustic style. In doing that, we're gonna go with a completely different finish on this stucco. See, right now, this is just a regular sand, traditional stucco finish, and it's kind of actually meant to be aged and nicely set up, so it has different colors and things like that. But along with that, it's a subpar installation, meaning that there's a few things that we needed to correct, a few things we needed to touch base on and fix with the restoration we're going to do here. And we're going to go back with a completely synthetic acrylic stucco system and redo a couple things there. Also, the main thing that it's going to solve is, you know, like I said earlier, the harsh weather here, the salt air, the sun just beating down constantly really can take its toll on a home. So we're going to preempt that, okay? We're going to make sure when we go back with the soffit fascia system, we're going to go back with pressure treated wood in the areas that have been rotted already. We're going to come back with a primer, use a lifetime primer, lifetime caulk, lifetime Sherwin-Williams duration paint. And then we're going to go on this stucco, like I mentioned too, with a easy to clean, nice surface for that as well. And we'll look at the color charts a little bit later, but follow me here. I'll show you a couple of the issues. Okay, so we have a few issues here. One, like I mentioned, it was not very easy to clean. We've actually already cleaned and pressure washed this structure, preempting this and getting ready to prep. But just by doing that, part of these trim pieces that stuck on the trim pieces, which is the cement board, has came off. The main reason, there was a step that was missed here, and there should be a polymer lath that's actually on there, or a metal lath going over the cement board to prevent it from falling off or cracking and allows for structural integrity. So we're going to correct that. In all these sections, we're going to redo the trim sections there, and like I said, go back with a primer, a bonding coat, and then a final synthetic acrylic stucco that really has a nice clean finish, clean look, and something that the client's going to be very pleased with. So hey guys, so perfect example, just paying attention to a little bit of details here. This is just a simple thing that sometimes can be missed when building a home. You know, not proper finishes on the soffit fascia. This board was just not butted up right, the 45 was not made. And something like this, especially at eye level when you're standing, you can see this very plain as day. It's only, you know, 8 feet up above the ground. And these areas have to be, you know, tightened up and buttoned up perfectly. So, you know, one little mistake like this doesn't ruin the whole architecture of the whole house and the whole area. It really can be an eyesore indeed. We're going to come back, we're going to place these two sections here, take it off, fix it right, come back with pressure treated wood for the soffit board, and then like I said, go back with a primer, a deep color match primer, then do the final color match Sherwin-Williams duration paint with a caulk as well and seal everything up, and we'll be good to go. So here's just some of the, you know, the damage that, you know, this harsh weather and this harsh sun and the environment, this marsh area, riverfront section, really can do to an exterior board. So this is a soffit board. You know, some of the things that could have been prevented, this could have been a pressure treated board, number one. Number two, we could have done a primer on this and, you know, a longer, some more sustainable paint that has an elastomericity to it. So it actually flexes, you know, doesn't crack in the sun per se, and lasts a lot longer. That's what we're going back with, of course. So, but you can see even in these sections, it went all the way back to the wood. And so here, so there's a lot of sections like this all over the soffit fascia. So instead of going back with something that's just not going to go with the architecture of the house, like, you know, vinyl or aluminum, we're just going to do the wood product properly. We're going to actually install and do a repair properly, so it's going to last, you know, a long time and for the long haul. Hey guys, so this is the issue with the stucco here. Like I mentioned before, this is a, you know, a sand stucco structure they put directly onto a cement board. No lath, no anything. Really just the installation was done improperly here. This should have all been covered with a lath and a mesh, and some people would say. and then a, you know, bond coat, then a final coat. But this is a one-stage system sand. It's porous. It allows moisture through into the house. And also, you know, temperature and energy efficiency wise, it's just really a subpar product. So we're going back with a completely synthetic stucco, really gonna finish it out nicely and fix all these main cracking issues. As you can see, this stuff's just coming right off. So, you know, this is a beautiful, absolutely beautiful estate, beautiful home. It has some great insulations, you know, the pool, the way it's set up. And we have some great stone and inlays with the pavers and tile down at the pool area, the diving stone down there. We're gonna do quite a bit to this. This is the first phase we're gonna go through, just the exterior of the home, and then we're gonna kind of move ourselves out. Some railings, everything's gonna be done as well. But this is what I mean about balancing this old world style. Right now it's still very rustic. So we have this, you know, stone section here with all the railing. We have the stone tiles on the base here. And then of course this stucco. This is an old world stucco. It's more of a rustic feel. I wanna clean that up a little bit. It's important to remember though, when you change a architectural theme or design style, you have to make sure you balance. Because if we just went back and decided, okay, you know, we're just gonna make this perfectly flat, change it, sharp hard edges, and not think of colors as well. These rustic and nice eclectic styles like this, like the stone and like the rails here, they would just be an eyesore. So we have to make sure we balance that. We have to bring some of the colors out with the colors we choose with the stucco and also with the final trim paint for the soffit fascia as well. Hey guys, so another thing we're touch basing on. So we have this exterior renovation phase one, which is a complete exterior renovation of the stucco and everything that's structurally unsound. But also we're having an issue a little bit with water as well. So we're on this top patio section, on this top roof line here, we're gonna install a gutter system that shoots over each side of these pitches of the roof on the corner turrets and diverts most of that 90% of that rainwater away. So we're not having a bunch of spillage here on the kind of entertaining area and things like that. Then also gonna put a piece of flashing underneath this section here between the two step sections there above those columns there too. So it keeps, again, to keep the water away from splashing in, getting people wet, you know, when you're entertaining underneath your underdeck and kind of outdoor kitchen area underneath there. Okay, so if we can go this way, I'll show you a couple more things. So this is a perfect example of, you know, a deterioration issue. So there was a bunch of vines over here on this stucco. Right now you can kind of see the lines and the old ways. In fact, a little piece of the vine left, we still got to get off and clean off there before we do our primer coat on this stucco system here, the new stucco system we're doing. That vines actually eat into and use the minerals inside of the stucco to live. So if they're on the side of the house without some kind of separated barrier, like a some kind of lattice or something like that that keeps them away, they are actually deteriorating the stucco every single year that goes by. So be very careful when you're installing any kind of plants like that are runners and have the root runners on them, because they can actually destroy your structure and can be quite invasive and expensive. Another issue we have here is the main, so we had some critter issues on this deal, meaning that inside the garage doors and things like that, critters are getting inside. So we're gonna make sure we seal up all these sections around the doors so they're pretty much airtight, putting new flashes around the outside and also caulking around them as well. And then a little thing that's aesthetic, you know, most people wouldn't notice this, but it does catch an eye, and those little eyesores that stick out can ruin a whole design. So there's a vent section up there, that's a pretty significantly sized vent if you could see it. And it's a brown color right now. We're actually gonna paint that to match the stucco. So it's gonna blend away. And so when you're walking by and passing, it's not something that's gonna catch your eye and take away from the beauty of this whole estate. Hey guys, so far this has been a good kind of showcase of the first steps that we're gonna take in renovating this project and this house here for the clients. Again, taking a smooth, clean look and tone, balancing it with the already rustic elements that are involved. This is the first phase, so we're looking to the other phase as well, but check into the next episodes too, and we'll see you next time. It's been Around the House with Calvin. Thanks a lot, guys.
Your foot now, don't stomp it too hard.
You want me to just tippy toe it, man? Okay, huh? Right. So, blah, 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 blah. You know, staying in tune, keep watching, and we'll see you next time. It doesn't move.
Stutter, yeah,
it's welded, rusted shut. Away. Yeah.
You stutter too, Eddie.
What did I say? Yeah.
Keep on watching and stay tuned. Keep on watching.
Dude, you're talking. Are you really about me stuttering?
Stay tuned.
Right, I need you on this side of the camera soon.
One, three, two, one.